morning. Today is the 14th of June.
And now we are waking up to a very good villa and the sun is shining. And we are our tent. And actually there are storks. So now I want to show you where the storks are. Here you can see right in distance there are some storks. And our tent are right there. Yes, and the storks are there. So yes, and the big one was actually just flying. I can just see it over there. So this is the funny thing today in the morning. So let's see to the breakfast.
Okay, just enjoy the nice breakfast here. It's time to get packed away. Bags loaded and look out onto the road over there. You can just see the road just there. That's the road to Armenia that way. And we'll 15 kilometers should be at the border of Armenia.
Yeah, and this is pretty flower. It's very beautiful. So this is to this is the flower to everyone that have seen our video.
Okay. All packed away. Ready to go. Really enjoy camping here in this purple flower field here. Really nice. An amazing sunset we watched yesterday, so that was good. Nice and quiet. Okay, let's get back on the road.
Try to bike to Armenia. Yeah. 15 kilometers should be. But they have some headwind today and we're told that the road is bad, so we'll see how long time that takes.
Yeah. Okay, bikes are rolling again. We haven't actually got used to this Georgian time yet, since 11 o'clock, so. But if we still think we're in Turkish time, it's only 10 o'clock, so that's okay. But, yeah, we'll have a ride to the border now, see how that crossing is, if it's as easy as the one from Turkey to Georgia. We'll see. Okay, didn't take long for the road to deteriorate, just like our German friends told us, but nothing compared to Iceland yet, so it's okay.
This roads are very Albanian style.
Yes.
Just see how much dust they are coming from the lorry.
Like Iceland and Albania mixed together. Yeah, like some of the houses actually looked nice at one point. Now they're all in a battle of disrepair. One thing we haven't seen in these last few towns, you don't see men sitting in coffee shops as we've done in Croatia. In fact, all the way through Greece and Turkey, you see a kind of town centre where people just sit there and hanging around. We haven't seen that here. Just come through, you see the odd person here and there, and that's it really. A lot of the cars, they look like something from the Soviet Union. The truck drivers in this part of the world, they have to help each other. When one breaks down like they did back there, four others stop and help him on the fix the problem. We're about 5 kilometers now from the border. Nice countryside again. Basically crawling uphill since we had our lunch yesterday. Still going uphill, dodging holes. Now we're very close to the border. It'll be interesting to see what happens to the road after the border, if it gets worse or better or just the same. We'll see. Okay, looks like this actually is the border. Steel tent. Okay, that didn't take long here. 3 stamps. Stamped here for Georgia. Let's go to the other one over there. It's like a newer building in Armenia. There's the Georgian flag there. Okay, let's go.
See you at Armenian border. Bye-bye.
The road here in no man's land between the borders, that's very nice.
Very good. It feels like home now.
Smoothest road we've been on all day. Okay, let's see how we get in Armenia. Okay, this is the Armenian side. Let's see if we can get stamped into Armenia. Okay, that wasn't as easy as we thought. Actually here, it wasn't an advantage to have a Danish passport because the border guard had absolutely no idea what Denmark was. This is as if he'd never even heard of the word Denmark in his life.
Yeah.
This is amazing. We just spent 10 minutes trying to show him on the map, Google Maps, what Denmark was, and it was close to Germany and Sweden, and never seen a guy look so puzzled ever. So
he looked in our passports and was trying to ask us, Germany, France, Denmark, no, he didn't know. But then after he's looked at what, 10 minutes, then he says, welcome to Armenia.
Yeah, so I think he called somebody and they must have told him what Denmark was, and then he seemed to be okay. Oh, that was good. We're going to get stuck here on the border. So that was the time it was good to have a British passport because that went through really easy.
Yes.
Oh, strange. Okay, let's. Now we're here anyway, in Armenia.
See if we can change some money in here next to the border.
Change our Georgian money back to, from Georgian to Armenian. And then we'll see what it's like here in Armenia.
Yeah. The Armenian link.
Okay, our first purchase in Armenia.
Espresso.
Okay, we're on the road in Armenia. Is it a road or is it a dirt track? Let's see. It should be the start of two interesting weeks in Armenia. Wasn't actually a country we were planning to visit from the start. The only reason we came here is because I had a delay picking up my Iran visa, so we thought we would spend the time by seeing Georgia and Armenia instead of just hanging around at the border of Turkey and Iran. So now we've got 2 weeks here. What I've been reading takes about 2 weeks to cross from north until south. It's a very mountainous country, and also in the south we have some really big mountains to climb, so probably be a bit challenging biking, but we've heard there's lots to see here and extremely beautiful landscape. Something here that we haven't seen since Greece. That is actually a sign for camping. At the fuel station. And a diesel pump there. This road, believe it or not, is called the M1. It's not really the same as the M1 that goes from London up north in England. Okay, that's the two towns we're heading for now, Gyumri and Yerevan. I prefer to read the writing on the bottom, not the top. Really nice road here. We're climbing again, that's where we were earlier. Hello. Hi, dogging. Oh, a lot of sheep here. Wow. Hello? Oh, real cowboys. Wow. Hello, hello. Yeah, one of the main reasons cycling tourists, they come to Armenia is the mountains. See, especially in the south, there's lots of big mountains. We can see it's just starting to appear now in the distance, some snow-capped mountains there, so it's going to be some really nice picturesque days we have ahead of us, if you like mountains. this is our first real climb in Armenia. Nothing too difficult, but quite steep. There's some beautiful rolling hills to look at. Hello. Pretty big climb, really. Didn't expect it to be so big. Amazing, some of the cars here. These like models I've never seen before in my life, even though I thought I knew a lot about cars. I know nothing until I got to this place. Look like this truck here, got no idea what this is. Could be 50 years old. A lot of the cars, they look like 40 years old from the old Soviet Union. Or truck. Anybody can tell us the name and model of that truck, then send us a comment.
Yes.
Hey, this is the main town square here in Gyumri. It's the first town we've been to here in Armenia. Okay, this is our first Armenian hotel. It's actually quite expensive. We told we wouldn't pay that much because we're used to Turkish prices, so we got it for Turkish prices, but now I can actually see it's quite a nice room. Okay. Well, okay, fair enough. It's a bit more expensive than Turkey. We expected the opposite, that the standard would go down.
Yeah, and a nice toilet.
It's really nice.
Okay, very good, fair enough.
We just have pizza today because we don't want to have pasta and lentils the same, but now we are glad to have some new food again.
In the midst of all this rubble and falling down buildings, we found this really nice modern looking pizza restaurant, so we couldn't resist stopping here. And guess what, they even have beer. We didn't even know what that was. We've forgotten.
We'll try that today.
So that sounds like fun. So we'll try that. Now we're in the town city here, city center. Oh, this looks like fun. Okay, so that was the end of our first, what, half a day in Armenia. So first impressions are quite good. People seem to be happy and friendly, waving along as we go, smiling. That's always nice to see. That's a little bit of the same feeling that we had when we was in Albania, so that's nice. But we'll see. We've only been here half a day. The plan is now that we'll stay here the next 2 weeks. So heading south. Next place we're going to is Yerevan. So we'll see. Not sure yet whether we're going to take the train tomorrow or we're going to cycle there. We have to decide in the morning. So we'll see what we decide. But the main plan is just to work our way south, and then we'll get to the border of Iran in 2 weeks' time. We have to cross the border on the 29th of June. So, but yeah, sounds like a fascinating place. It's a country about the size of Belgium with a population of 3 million people. So, yeah, it's not too many people here. It's quite a mountainous country, so we'll be seeing plenty of that in the next few days. Also, the politics is quite fascinating at the moment as well. So, just been a kind of small revolution here in the last month, so I'll tell you more about that in the next few days when we get to Yerevan. So, yeah, it's basically it for today, and we'll see what we do tomorrow, whether we go to Yerevan or get back on the bikes. Okay, see you tomorrow.